Venezuela is launching its very own cryptocurrency. Petro will be backed by oil, gas, gold, and diamonds. It's supposed to help tackle Venezuela's overwhelming debt and prop up its failing economy by circumventing U.S. sanctions. Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro announced it on Sunday. The move into the crypto world is surprising because right now, some Venezuelans say they're going to prison for dealing in Bitcoin. Venezuela was once the richest country in South America, but now it's a country in crisis. It has the highest inflation rate in the world, and its currency is in freefall. Some say it's because the Venezuelan government views cryptos as a threat to the already weak Bolivar and to its strict rules about capital flight. It's been a lifeline for people like this man, who goes by the nickname Brother. He initially got into mining because his $43 a month government job wasn't enough to support the baby girl he and his wife had on the way. The 29-year-old started mining by secretly using computers in his government office and only agreed to talk to CNBC under anonymity. Brother's story is a familiar one. Andrea Perez works three jobs, yet mining Bitcoin represents roughly 80% of her income.
For me, Bitcoin has represented the ability to be able to support and feed my daughter in a very volatile environment.
Mining cryptocurrency is completely legal in Venezuela, yet police have been arresting miners. The national police say in many of these cases, suspects were exploiting resources without documentation. That's because mining takes up a whole lot of electrical power, and power is basically free in Venezuela because of state subsidies. But despite the crackdown on cryptocurrencies, they remain a key source of income for Venezuelans. Venezuela's currency, the Bolivar, has lost 99% of its value in 5 years, but Bitcoin, Ether, and other cryptocurrencies are insulated from all that. They're fully decentralized, so they're immune to what's happening in any one country, regardless of where they're mined. And though extremely volatile, cryptos are proving to be one of the most stable things in Venezuela right now. But it remains to be seen if the Petro would offer that same stability, since the cryptocurrency is pegged to commodities like oil.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.